same thing all the time. No, I hear you, Holy Spirit. I got you. I submit. Yeah, I heard you. You want the purpose to be the same thing. Well, I'm sorry to have to tell y'all this morning. Purpose changes. Purpose changes. Purpose changes. Okay, so explain it a little bit further. I will. I'm glad y'all asked. I love it when y'all ask me to do stuff. I'm going to explain it a little further. Well, I started my journey out. I was a worship leader. That was my purpose for that season. And then, you know, and then I went off into being a part of prayer. That was my, you know, my purpose in for that season. And then I ended up going off into a girl talk and mentoring. Look at that purpose for that season. And then ended up into the purpose of Pastor Lee. Look at that purpose in that season. Now it's Apostle of Prayer. It is Apostle Lee. Look at them purposes all manifesting themselves. Look at them different purposes all. But if I had said, you know, I'm just going, Delphine, you go, it's too early. Yep, girl. If I had said, I'm just going to keep on leading worship because that's just who I am. And that's what the people love for me to do, you know, because I can move the crowd now. You know what I'm saying? I probably still could do a heck of a good worship leading session because I could move the crowd. You know, it's just I'm drop dead serious and probably much better now because my passion for God is much more greater. You know, but if I had did that because that's what people wanted me to do and they thought that that was all I was supposed to do when it really wasn't for me, it was for them. They liked the way it made them feel. You know, they liked it for me to pump them up, because if you don't watch people, even in church arenas and all, they'll use the hell out of you. I said it just like a minute. They'll use the hell out of you. That means an extremity of use right there. When they say use the hell out of you, that means they don't take it to the extreme. They will use you in that capacity in order to make them feel good, because you know what I'm saying? They don't know how to go into prayer themselves and to build themselves up on their most holy faith. So then they need all that right there in order to get them pumped up and amped up to feel God. When all you have to do to feel God is to draw from that, like Jude said, he says, praying ye in the Holy Ghost and in your most holy faith. When all you have to do to get the presence of God is to literally talk about God, or to literally just engage or worship God, to enter into his gates with thanksgiving and come into his courts with praise. That's all you have to do in order to engage God. But they would think that you gotta have all of this. You gotta do this singing. So what if I had to let them kept me restricted? And I'm telling y'all, I've been had a headache for 3 days and it's like it's trying to just hit me right now. But I don't guess the enemy know that I've made a vow and I won't take it back. I don't guess he know that. You know what I'm saying? I made a vow, man, and I won't take it back. You know, I'll do it. However, I don't already say it. I'll die with this, so let's just period. It is what it is. But if I had said, I'm just going to stay here and do worship, you know, be a worship leader, because this is what they like, you know what I'm saying? The people enjoy this. Oh my God, look at how, you know, they just dancing and, oh God, everybody just, crying and they just, patting me, oh, Sister Delphine, oh God, God used you today. Now, what if I had just stuck with that, you know, and stayed right there and let my purpose been just that? What if I had just did that? Let me just be honest, you know, I don't know how to be nothing else, no way, but listen, let me show y'all something here. People will literally restrict you to what they want you to do, but they'll keep changing in their life now. Their life will keep elevating and keep going, but they'll want you to stay right there in that same Frank Delphine. Want you to stay right there in that same position that you in, locked in right there, because they need you for their use, God. Oh, the Bible even shows that they need you for their use. I want you to just stay here and just play this harp whenever I have an evil spirit on me, and because you're the one that knows how to do it. That's why Saul did not want to get rid of David, because David brought about certain things. That's why Laban didn't want to get rid of Jacob, because Jacob brought about certain things. He said, long as Jacob was around, there was blessings that was, God help me on this morning. There was blessings that wasn't around. I told y'all you don't need all that. All you need to do is just talk about God and let him use you and produce the truth. You don't have to have all of that. You don't have to lock a person's life up into one frame of being because that's what you think you need them for. That's what you got to have them for. No, allow people to expand and to move into different purposes that God would have for them. Many people have been prophesied to that they would do great things and be great things and literally prophesy their next purpose, but can't walk in that purpose because somebody holding them back, restricting them back, won't allow them to be free to walk into that purpose. But can I tell y'all something? When the Holy Spirit, God is going to get tired. I'm telling you, we're in the grace dispensation now, but if you read your word, I ain't read the whole Bible yet still, but I can tell you this. In the word, it says that grace will be lifted. So the dispensation of grace to which we are under at some point in time is going to be lifted. And when it is lifted, then the wrath of God, that is what I was going to show in Ephesians 5 anyway, in case y'all thought I didn't have no scriptures. Yes, I do. And then when the wrath of God begins to come in, and oh, God help me, it says it's going to come to the children of disobedience. Why would we be called children of disobedience? Because if the word has been spoken, then it was spoken to be obeyed. God help me this morning. But if it's not obeyed, then it literally comes as a disobedience. Father, help me this morning. If I hear prophetic words that is spoken over any of your lives, and I literally become a rock of offense or a stumbling block in order to stop you from producing that which God has said, I'm now in the spirit of disobedience or in the spirit of delay, or the spirit of causing you to literally be disobedient. So there are two acts of disobedience. I'm disobedient in the act or the nature of, I'm going to try to stop this. You would be disobedient in the nature of yielding to me trying to stop it and not moving in what has been spoken or released. Can I tell y'all something? Prophetic words are spoken in an effort to recalibrate your life to get you to the next place of where it is that God would have for you to be and to do what God would have for you to do. Delphine, look here. This is the thing about it. You have to literally allow yourself when you turn. I'm trying to help some folk turn on their new road this morning. That's what I'm trying to do. Just trying to help you turn on your new road. But when you turn on your new road, don't go on your new road now thinking that you're going to take all this from over here. Go on your new road saying it's a whole new world in front of me. I've got to pay attention to the new things. I've got to drop down into student mode. I can't drive the car as fast as I had gotten used to driving the car. I got to chill out because I need to see the beauty of this road. And I need to be able to study this road to see exactly what it is. My God, y'all see that house over there? That's a beautiful house over there. My God, look at that scenery right there. Ooh, Lord, have mercy. It'll even put you in a mind frame of back when you was a child where you would look at them and say, ooh, I would like to have that right there. That mind right there. Oh, my God, look at that. You see how the sun sets right there over that place? That is so beautiful right there. In this new place that God is teaching, it is a new opportunity. My God, and then you will drive and see that there is a whole parcel of land that has not been occupied. And the Lord will say to you in the new place, that's yours. What you say, God? I said, that's yours. Right there. See, that's yours. That's why I sent you down this path. That's why I, God help me, I sent you, Delphine. I sent you down this journey because I needed to let you see that that's yours right there. Lord, have mercy. You didn't have it on the other journey. Lord, have mercy. But the new purpose has now brought you to that that is yours. God, help me on this morning. It has brought you to that is yours. It's now brought you to this new place. Oh, but baby, if you don't slow down and if you bring in everything from over there, you know, you even bring in people from over there, because you've gotten so used to crutching with them and all You're going to miss the beauty of your new thing. Take me for a joke this morning, y'all. Take it for a joke. You're going to miss the beauty of your new thing. Father, I love you. I love you, man. You're going to miss the beauty of your new thing. It's a new purpose upon you. It's a new purpose upon you. Let me tell you, I don't care how much you consider yourself can hear God. I don't care how many words God will give you to give. When you go in a new place, you better hush. Lest you miss what God is trying to do new. I hear the Spirit of the Lord this morning, and I hear Him saying, I keep hearing the word fumes, and I'm like, what are you talking about, God? Fumes. See, there are many that are just existing off of fumes. It's no fresh wind. It's fumes. The oil is old in that place. It's over with. It's no new oil. It's no new freshness. It's over with. Any questions or comments?
Amen. Amen. Awesome word. Father, help us to transition to our new.
Ephesians 5. Ephesians 5. I'll start at verse 6. I'll grab a couple of verses for the sealing of the word. Ephesians 5, verse 6. It says this here, let no man deceive you with vain words. Let no man deceive you with vain words. I wish I had time to help y'all with all of this. Please know when you read the Bible has a natural meaning, meaning that it speaks in a parable or symbolic nature, and it also has a spiritual meaning. That word man in the natural would be someone under demonic influence of in a natural world, but then that word man means spirit man, which means what lives on the inside. So let no man, nor let an external demonic force, neither allow an internal demonic force to deceive, which means to appear to be, but really not it, but really is not. So let no internal or external spiritual man pretend to be to you, present themselves to you with vain words, vain meaning, just puffed up. They're prideful. That's what vain is. Vain has a lot of pride attached to it. It's no humility. It says words means that it's going to be something that will be said, not always something that'll be done, but something that will be said. Most people are in fear of what people will say. I don't know what she gonna say. I don't